Kia ora, Lara here. I'm going to share with you the Wanda collection by Close to My Heart, which is the July feature collection in the new, or the not so new anymore, mini catalogue. And so I've just flicked through the papers here. There's a cool sticker sheet. They've got, some of them got a bit of a shine, and there was some pretty cool cardstock embellishments there. So I have selected a couple of the papers to scrapbook a tramp that my husband went on in May this year, and perfect for this sort of Wanda, which is a really outdoorsy feel. You can sort of see the word nature on the stamps up to the right there, and it kind of follows along that theme: tramping, hiking, weekends, adventuring, climbing mountains and things like that. So what I'm doing here is I am gutting this paper that's got quite a few of the elements of tramping or hiking or that summer outdoors adventure. May over here is more autumn than summer. It's a good time for locals to go and use some of our tramping huts and things because there's less people out there trying to use them. So now that I've gutted that large sheet of paper, I'm now cutting an inch off each side of this green paper, which is sort of like a topographic map, kind of, with the way the sort of the shapes and things are on there. There's just a slightly darker pattern on it. So the embellishment cardstock sheet that I showed you at the start there has all these pretty cool frames, and as I was looking at them and using some of the other pieces of this, I thought it'd be quite fun to do a layout with lots of the frames on it, making a feature of these. So I've popped them all out from the cardstock background. I won't end up using all of these shapes, but I'll use most of them, and you'll see how that works unless you saw the thumbnail of this video, which had a bit of a picture of it. So I'm just sort of arranging the frames here so that they will fit on the paper, just to make sure and to see which ones I'm going to want to use and how I'm going to try and make that look. So I do come up with a bit of an arrangement, and I do end up changing that later on. So here's the photos. There's one there just of the map of the tramp that they were doing and a few shots. Some of the photos I don't end up using. I trim it down just to be only the ones that tell the story of doing the old ghost road, which was the walk that they did. This layout doesn't document some of the nastier parts of this tramp, such as the bed bugs that were in some of the huts. However, he didn't bring any home, did get a few bites, but was super cautious, sort of smoke bombing or whatever his sleeping bag and things before, and leaving them outside for a couple of weeks before bringing them inside. So not so nice, the idea of it, but it worked okay. So I have backed the little frame pieces here with some of the current mix-ins. So these are the July-August mix-ins, and I've just chosen two of those papers, and I have stuck them to the back of all those frames and stuck those down. And now I am matting the photos that I've selected to pop on the page, and one of these photos doesn't end up making the cut in the final piece. But that's okay, it just is part of telling the story. And what do I need to tell the story? Now I do use some thin foam tape to mount these because the frames are an uneven background, and the foam tape helps to compensate for that. So now I've popped them down, and I've chosen some of the stickers out from the sticker sheet as well that I'm just going to also put foam tape on the back of, because they are the ones anyway that are going on the frames on that uneven surface are going to have some foam tape on them. So the drink bottle, just done a couple of layers of that and tucked it in. I really liked that mountainy kind of scene that's on it, and the same with the mountains on that wee circle. I didn't have to use the foam tape on the circle or on some of these shapes that I am sticking inside some of the frames, as if that was part of why they were there. I really like how this is looking, but I feel like it just needs something else, and I kind of spy the stamp sets there and see a couple that I think are going to work really well on this page. So I've started with the word adventure, which I'm going to stamp here. I'm always a bit reluctant to put stamps on at the very end of a page. However, there are always ways of covering up or fixing things up if you need to. And so after using the adventure stamp, I also pulled out some of these little plus signs, or if they're on the side, they could be X's, like X marks the spot. But I just really liked popping them on here. So there's an outline one, and then there is a bold filled one. I've used the archival black so far, but I do bring out some of the espresso ink to do some more of these after I've done both the filled in and the emptied plus sign. So just randomly placing these on pieces of parts of the layout that help to give a little bit of a balance. So while I was putting this together, including where the frames and things are, I was trying to mix up the pattern papers and the coloured frames and where they all fit. So here I have now got the espresso ink pad out, and I am just going around again with these little plus signs on the layout and stamping them at various points. Now, I'm not sure if I showed you this, but the Versa mat has got a great surface for doing cutting and all sorts of things on it, but if you turn it over like I have here, it's got a really a foam back, and so I use this if I'm doing stamping on the full background of the layout, and I normally just use the smaller one that comes in the ink pads in the stamp sets to back smaller pieces. So I've chosen one of the journaling sort of spots or journaling squares from the cardstock sticker, and I am just adding some journaling on there. I did have to go back onto my phone to find when they went on this tramp, and I finished that journaling a little bit later on. On the sticker sheet there was also some of these little plus signs, but in different colours, so I'm just going around now and popping them onto the page at different points, just to add a little bit more interest, a bit more colour to the layout design. So just I chose a rust, I think there was a yellow and a navy blue plus sign on here that I did, and I chose sort of the location icon here, and I popped it onto the photo I'd taken of the map of the walk. So here's just a few closer up shots of the layout and how it came together. So I hope this gives you a few ideas of how you could use the Wanda collection, and look forward to hearing what you do with this collection, and if you've enjoyed using it or not. Hey, thanks for watching, and if you've liked this video, please subscribe. Thank you.